If you're happy and you know it, pour a dram. If you're happy and you know it, pour a dram. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, pour yourself a dram. Quick to pour. Slow to nose. Always enjoyed. Well, hello there, all you malty mini bottlers. Clue, Ralphie here. Bringing you a Ralphie Stuff whisky review, number 77. And I'm going to take this opportunity to expand your knowledge about things whisky by giving you a brief introduction to the very small scale independent bottlers. There's not many of them out there. They're hard to find, the bottles, but when you do see them in the shelves in your whisky shop, when you do see them cropping up on eBay, give them a second glance, because they could be proved to be very good whisky. Let me elaborate. Old school sherry. The people who bottle whisky are usually the producers. The people who own the distilleries bottle what they distill, and they put it out there as official bottlings. But you also have another group of people, of companies, who bottle whisky. And although they may occasionally own a distillery or two, what they're basically selling is a whole range of distilleries, single cask. And important to these guys is that they appreciate who their customers are, and they don't put caramel into their whisky and induce that fake tan stuff. They don't chill filter. And they tend to bottle at a higher than usual strength of 40%. So it's either cask strength or it's 46 or 50, around about there. Now, these independent bottlers, I'll give you an example. You have Gordon and MacPhail of Elgin, a large traditional setup with vast stocks of good whisky. And you will find these in your bars and in your majority of whisky shops. You also have Signatory, another good example, a much more recent company who are bottling a wide range of distillery produced whisky through unofficial channels. And interestingly, these guys tend to have closed down distilleries, what they call silent stills, like Port Ellen, Brora, Little Mill. These are the guys that have these whiskies, if those are the whiskies you're looking for. You have the small independent bottlers. A good example is Compass Box, based in London, who are much admired by the whisky anoraks and who tend to produce consistently excellent and very original bottles of whisky. And I suggest you look out for Compass Box. It's a whisky I will certainly be keen to review in the not so distant future, because they go places with bottles of whisky that other distillers fear to tread. And we admire them for that. But on the table, I have three examples of mini independent bottlers. Now, what to do if you want to get more information about these guys? One of the best sources is the internet, of course. There we go. Stay where you are, guys. I'll come round and lead you through this. Go to whiskyfun.com, which is Serge Valentin's site, and scroll down. You're looking at the left-hand side of the page, and when you get past the cartoony bits and his listy bits, and past this, just underneath the Malt Maniacs and Whiskey Fun goodies, because they do goodies, you will get to the strange bits on bottlers. Now, pop that one up, and you will have a Malt Maniacs bottler ranking. What they've done is from their huge almanac of whiskey scores, over 30,000, by the way, huge amount, and generally pretty accurate. They have listed in order of excellence the independent bottlers, starting off with number one, Samaroli, Sistanti, The Bottlers, Moon Import, Whiskey Fair, etc., etc. Pop that to one side, because you now know where to find it. Your traditional mini independent bottlers are bottling one cask, a dozen casks, at the most about 20 a year. It does vary a bit. Their emphasis is purely on one individual, generally, one person who is experienced with whiskey, using their experience, their nose, to say, I'll pick this one, I'll pick this cask, I won't pick these others. It's my standards, I set the standards, and this is what I'm looking for. And these independent bottles like Kingsbury, Silver Seal, Sistanti, Samaroli, The Bottlers, are extremely sought after by your eclectic collectors because their contents are generally very high quality. They're certainly original presentation, no fake tans, no chilli fills, and bottled at cask strength. But these, despite being expensive bottles, you can still get a hold of them occasionally. When you can get hold of those, have a look at the new kids in the block. Bladnach Forum and Regis Whisky Mad. Let me introduce these guys. These have cropped up just in the last couple of years. They are mini independent bottlers. Regis is a very articulate presenter of all things whisky. He is a Frenchman with a particularly good nose. And I have noticed from tasting and nosing his whiskies, his choice of whiskies, that he's very aware of the quality of the cask and how it relates to the whisky. I get the impression he's not looking at what the whisky does, but he's concentrating on the relationship between the cask and the whisky. It's fascinating. All whiskies in this label are very good, and many are very affordable. Look out for them. Raymond, he picks the whisky for the Bladnach Whisky Forum, and he's doing a very good job of it too. Now, Raymond would be the first to admit he does not have a super blender's nose, but personally I think he's better than he gives himself credit for, because he is purchasing old third fill refill casks where it is the signature of the still, the original quality and personality of the spirit, which is coming through with the cask in the background, supporting the spirit from a distance. So although you'll get some grand old age statements in these bottles, they're still very affordable, very well priced, and you're getting a very young, younger than its years, whisky for your pound, euros and dollars. Now, I'm going to conclude by saying that I'll be reviewing this bottler's whisky shortly. It's one of Zabir, who owns Rayburn Wines in Edinburgh. He has picked this. He is responsible for the bottler's selection. They are consistently well thought of and good. They are expensive, but you are getting very good whisky. And it's interesting to note that his personal choice is for good, old school, robust, beefy sherry casks. And this one, 16-year-old Springbank, I think it's about £70, so it's not cheap, but I've already had a snifter and it's very good indeed. I'll be coming to these shortly. If you would like to know more, Ralphie.com, dippy dippy doo, and I hope to see you shortly for the review of this bottler's Springbank. It'll be interesting. See you soon.